See, we are discussing numerical 48. Now, in this numerical, there are two hot bodies, B1 and B2, and the temperatures are given as 227 and 127 degrees Celsius. Now, here I will directly write temperature in what? Kelvin. Okay, I'll write T1 as 227 plus 273, and this as 127 plus 273. This is 500 and this is 400 Kelvin. Okay. The room temperature, they have mentioned as temperature surrounding is T0 27 degrees Celsius, that is 300 Kelvin. The relation between the rates of cooling of the two bodies R1 and R2. Okay. Now we know the formula R1 by R2 equal to T1 raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4 upon T2 raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. You have to compare the rate of cooling of bodies R1 and R2. Bodies B1 and B2, that is R1 by R2, you have to find. Now here simply you have to put the values. In simple manner, I'll write 5 into 10 raised to 2, the whole raised to 4, minus 3 into 10 raised to 2, the whole raised to 4, upon 4 into 10 raised to 2, the whole raised to 4, minus 3 into 10 raised to 2, the whole raised to 4. This 10 raised to 2 raised to 4 is common. What we get is 625 minus 81, 256 minus 81. Okay, and when you solve this, okay, 625 minus 81 upon, and when you divide this, this value comes out to be 3.1. So R1 by R2 will be 3.1, or R1 will be 3.1 into R2. This will be our final answer. Okay. Now the next numerical is numerical 49. I'll read it out. Listen. If the temperature of a hot body is increased by 5%, the amount of radiation emitted by it would increase by nearly dash. Okay. So initially the temperature of body is supposed T1, and the temperature is increased by 5%. Now how will you solve this? You have to find the amount of radiation increased. Now initially E1 is constant sigma into T1 raised to 4, and E2 will be sigma into T2 raised to 4, right? I have two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. Now what they have mentioned, T2 is T1 plus 5% of T1. T2 is what? T1 plus increase by 5%. Now 5% is what? 5 by 100, and that is what? 0.05 T1, or it comes out to be 1.05 T1. Correct? This is the value of what? T2. Now if I do E1 by E2, it will be T1 by T2 the whole raised to 4. I can write in this manner. Okay. And this can be written as T1 upon 1.05 T1 the whole raised to 4. Now T1 gets cancelled, right? And what remains is E2 will be E1 into 1.05 raised to 4. Now 1.05 raised to 4, using log, you can find this value. It comes out to be 1.22. Okay. Now what you have to find, this is 1.22 E1. Now percentage increase is given by E2 minus e1 upon e1 percentage. Okay, that is 1.22 e1 minus e1 upon e1. That is 0.22 e1 upon e1. That is nothing but 0.22. If you want to find percentage, you have to multiply by 100, and which comes out to be 22%. Right? So that's our final answer. So increase in the radiation will be 22%. Increase in the emission or radiation will be 22%. Friends, we move on to the next part about temperature and heat. First of all, see the relation between Celsius scale, Kelvin scale and Fahrenheit scale. This is a relation between Celsius and Fahrenheit. C will be 5 by 9 into bracket F minus 32. Okay? Or F will be 9 by 5 C plus 32. Many times simple numericals are asked based on this Fahrenheit and Celsius, and students lose marks because they don't remember this formula. Now third is the simplest one, Kelvin scale. To convert Celsius into Kelvin, you have to simply add 273. Now let's talk about the expansion in solids. The linear expansion is given by L2 equal to L1 1 plus alpha delta T, where alpha stands for coefficient of linear expansion, given by L2 minus L1 upon L1 into delta T. Delta T is the difference in temperature. For superficial or aerial expansion, I write A2 equal to A1 1 plus beta delta T, or beta equal to A2 minus A1 upon A1 delta T. Similarly, for volume expansion, V2 equal to V1 1 plus gamma delta T, where gamma is the coefficient of volume expansion, written as V2 minus V1 upon V1 delta T. Now, relation between alpha, beta and gamma is alpha is beta by 2 and alpha is equal to gamma by 3. Also, if we want to know the rate of flow of heat through a conductor, suppose a rod, rate of flow of heat is given by Q upon T. Q is a heat transferred upon time. It depends on K, A and delta theta by delta X. Now what is K? Coefficient of thermal conductivity. A stands for cross section area. Delta theta is the temperature difference between the two ends, and delta X is the distance between the two ends. Okay. Now the numerical which I am taking is based on the last formula, the rate of flow of heat. Okay. And it's a very simple numerical. Look at the board and understand it. There are four rods with different radii and length L are used to connect two heat reservoirs. Okay, there are two heat reservoirs and there are four rods used to convey heat, but the rods are of different radii, different thickness and all. Okay, which one will conduct most of the heat? Which one will conduct most of the heat from the first reservoir to the second reservoir? This is at high temperature and this is at low temperature, and heat is being conducted through four rods. Okay, four rods are there which conduct heat from reservoir 1 to reservoir 2. Now what they have mentioned, for the rod with radius as 1 centimeter and length equal to 1 meter, second, R is 1 centimeter and length is what? Half meter. C is R is 2 centimeter and length is 2 meters. And D, R is 2 centimeter, radius is 2 centimeter. Okay. And length is half meter. Now if you see this formula, Q by T equal to Ka, Q by T equal to Ka delta theta by delta X. From this formula it is understood that rate of flow of heat will be greater if area of cross section is larger. Right? and in this all the three, the area of cross section is largest in case of what? These two, r equal to centimeter and r equal to c and d have largest area of cross section. But it is inversely proportional to what? The length delta x. Now out of this, l length is 2 meter and here length is 0.5 meter. Okay, so if you look at d, the area of cross section is largest and the length is what? Lowest. And so our answer should be d. Okay, and correct, the answer is d. D is the correct option. Okay, hope you understood this. Now we will solve numerical 7, 8 and 9. Okay, what is the 7th one? Coefficient of cubical expansion of water is 0 at 0 degrees, 4 degrees, 15.5 or 100 degrees. Now what you know about water? Water shows anomalous behavior. Okay, when you cool water up to 4 degrees Celsius, it contracts. But below 4 degrees Celsius, it will not contract, it will expand. As a result, the cubical expansion, coefficient of cubical expansion for water will be 0 at 4 degrees Celsius. And the reason I told you, it is the anomalous behavior of water. Now, look at numerical 8. There is an iron sheet 40 cm into 20 cm and it is heated through 80 degrees Celsius. Right? Now, if alpha is 11 into 10 to the minus 6 per degree Celsius, the change in area is dash. Okay, there are four options. Let's find the answer. Now length is given. Area, initial area is given. 40 centimeter into 20 centimeter. 800 centimeter square. Okay. Now, what they are asking? Alpha is given. Alpha is 11 into 10 raised to minus 6 per degree Celsius. Okay. And the change in area. Change in area. That is A2 minus A1. This we have to find. Now, our formula, already we know. Formula A2 minus A1 is beta A1 into delta T. Okay. And delta T is also given. Delta T is what? 80 degree Celsius. Getting it? So I repeat, the change in area, you have to find A2 minus A1, alpha is given, delta T is given and area A1 is also given. So I will use this formula, A2 minus A1 equal to beta A1 into delta T. Now what is beta? Beta we don't know, but beta is what? 2 alpha. Okay. So A2 minus A1 will be 2 alpha into 2 alpha into A1 delta T. Okay. And this we put the value 2 alpha 2 into 11 into 10 raised to minus 6 into A1 is what? 800 centimeter square. To convert to meter square, I write 10 raised to minus 4 into temperature is what? 80 degree Celsius. And this, when you solve, okay, numerical, it's numerical 8. When you solve this, it comes out to be, now here they have not taken this in meter square, they have used directly centimeter square. So the increase in change in area is 1.4 centimeter square. This is our final answer. Okay. Now talk about numerical 9. Over here, the value of coefficient of volume expansion of glycerin is given. Okay. Coefficient of volume expansion of glycerin is 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 Kelvin inverse. Okay. They are asking you to find the fractional change in density of glycerin for a rise of 40 degrees. Delta T is what? 40 degrees Celsius. If they are asking you the fractional change in density of glycerin. Rho 1 minus rho 2 upon rho 1. This you have to find. Okay. Now, let the initial density be rho 1. And given by density is volume, mass upon volume, so m upon v1. Okay, and rho 2 will be m upon v2. Right, density is mass upon volume. So I get these two equations, but what is the relation between V2 and V1? We all know V2 is V1 into bracket 1 plus gamma delta T. Okay. Delta T is what? Change in temperature. I have taken the symbol small t. Delta T is a temperature. And this comes out to be what? 1 by this equation changes to what? V2 is rho 2 by m, right? What is 1 by V2? V2 is m upon, V2 is what? M upon rho 2, and this will be m upon rho 1, 1 plus gamma delta T. Is it okay? M gets cancelled, okay, and what you get is, I'll write here, 1 by rho 2 equal to 1 by rho 1 into bracket 1 plus gamma delta T, correct? Or I can write rho 2 equal to rho 1 upon 1 plus gamma delta T. Is it okay? Now, listen carefully. Fractional change can be written as the fractional change in density will be rho 1 minus rho 2 upon rho 1. And that becomes 1 minus rho 2 upon rho 1, right? But rho 2 upon rho 1 will be what? 1 minus rho 2, 1 plus gamma delta T, right? Clear? Now when you bring this in the numerator, what happens? It becomes 1 minus 1 plus gamma delta T raised to minus 1. And when we expand this, the negative sign will come here. It will become 1 minus 1 minus minus of minus is plus gamma delta T. Okay. And that is simply gamma delta. Now they have given the value of gamma, 5 into 10 raised to 4, 10 raised to minus 4, into 40, okay, and that comes out to be 0.020. This is the fractional change in density, fractional change in rho. This is our final answer.
We are talking about 11th numerical. The radius of a metal sphere at room temperature T is R, and the coefficient of linear expansion of metal is alpha. The sphere is heated a little by temperature delta T, so the new temperature is T plus delta T. The increase in the volume of the sphere is approximately dash. Okay.
Now what is mentioned in this numerical? There is a sphere. Sphere of what? Radius R. Radius is R. Its temperature is increased from T to T plus delta T. They are asking you to find change in volume. That is V2 minus V1 or delta V you have to find. Okay. But they have mentioned alpha. Alpha is the coefficient of linear expansion. But when you talk about volume, the formula contains gamma. But we know the relation between gamma and alpha. Gamma is what? 3 alpha. Remember this. Gamma is what? 3 times alpha. Okay. Now, let us now talk about the solution. Let initial volume V0 is 4 by 3. Pi R cube. Okay. Now as alpha equal to gamma by 3, we can write gamma equal to 3 alpha. And therefore, by formula, gamma is delta V upon V0 delta E. And that value is equal to 3 alpha. Right? Now, we got the answer. We want to find delta V. Delta V will be 3 alpha into V0 into delta T. 3 alpha into V0 is 4 by 3 pi R cube into delta T. 3 will get cancelled. And what remains? 4 pi R cube into alpha into delta T. This will be our final answer.
Now numerical 10th. The coefficient of linear expansion of brass and steel rods are alpha 1 and alpha 2. Length of brass rod and steel rods are L1 and L2 respectively. If L2 minus L1 is maintained same at all temperature, which one of the following relation holds good? There are four relations. Alpha 1 square L2 equal to alpha 2 square L1. Alpha 1 L1 equal to alpha 2 L2, alpha 1 L2 equal to alpha 2 L1, and alpha 1 L2 square equal to alpha 2 L1 square. Okay. There are two rods. One is of brass and other is of steel. One is having length L1, other is having length L2. Difference between the lengths is L2 minus L1. Okay. And alpha 1 and alpha 2 are the coefficients of linear expansion. Now we have to find the relation out of all these four, which one is the correct relation.
Now our general formula, we all know, is delta L equal to L 1 plus alpha delta. Now, similarly I can write this for delta L2 will be L2 1 plus alpha 2 delta. Capital T, small t, what is that? It's a difference in temperature. And delta L1 equal to L1 1 plus alpha 1 delta T. Okay, I get two equations. Now, L2 minus L1 will be what? Delta L2 minus delta L1. Okay? And now, substitute the value of delta L2 and delta L1. What we get here? L2 1 plus alpha 2 delta T minus L1 into bracket 1 plus alpha 2 alpha 1 delta T. When you open the brackets, what do you get? L2 plus L2 alpha 2 delta T minus L1 minus L1 alpha 1 delta. Correct? Or I can write all the L2 terms on one side and L1 terms on the other side. I can write minus L2, okay? Minus L2 plus L2. This is L2 already there. Minus L2 plus L2 plus L2 alpha 2 delta, right, equal to minus L1 plus L1 plus L1 alpha 1 delta. Okay, and L1 L2 will get cancelled. Finally, what remains? L2 alpha 2 delta T equal to L1 alpha 1 delta T. Or I can write L2 alpha 2 equal to, this is our final answer. Friends, let's move on to the topic of calorimetry. Now the topic is based on principle of heat exchange. See, when a object whose temperature is higher, okay, is brought in contact with a body which is having a low temperature under isothermal, under a insulated condition, means what? Heat should not escape out. Now, whatever heat is lost by the hot body will be the heat gained by the cold body. And a device which we use is called as a calorimeter. Okay. Now, a calorimeter is a simple wooden box in which there is an arrangement of a lid with a stirrer and a thermometer. Inside the calorimeter, there is a copper vessel. Understood? So, the copper vessel containing the water in it is to be considered as the cold body. Okay? And a hot sphere, solid sphere, maybe copper, iron, water is that, is put in the water and the lid is closed. Now, when you put a hot object in cold water, the hot object will lose heat, its temperature will decrease, and the cold water will show rise in temperature after absorbing heat. So the calorimeter and the water will absorb heat, the temperature will rise, and the temperature of the hot sphere will automatically decrease. So heat lost by the hot sphere will be the heat gained by the copper calorimeter and the water. Whatever heat is lost by the sphere will be the equal to the heat gained by the calorimeter and the water. That is the idea, and it is based on the principle of heat exchange. Whatever heat is lost by the hot body is equal to the heat gained by the cold body. Okay. Now, I will solve one numerical based on this. This numerical I will solve is numerical 20. Okay, numerical 20, and what is given there, I'll write in short. A copper ball of mass 100 grams. So mass of the sphere is given 100 gram, is at a temperature T. Now temperature is T1 equal to capital T. It is dropped in a copper calorimeter of mass 100 grams. The mass of calorimeter is also 100 gram. filled with 170 grams of water. Mass of water is 170 gram. Okay. At room temperature, the temperature of calorimeter and this, I'll write T2, both are T2, and that is what? Room temperature 30 degree Celsius. Okay. Now they have mentioned that subsequently the temperature of system is found to be 75 degrees. Now final temperature. Final temperature is 70 degree. So I wrote final temperature. Now understand this, a hot sphere is put in a calorimeter. A hot sphere will lose the heat and the water and calorimeter will gain the heat. So I will write heat lost by sphere equal to heat gained by water plus heat gained by calorimeter. Okay, this formula I will use. Now what is the heat lost by the sphere? Heat lost by sphere will be mass of the sphere, specific capacity of the sphere into falling temperature. Earlier temperature was T, now it has fallen to 75. So T minus 75, right? Now heat gained by water, mass of water, specific heat capacity of water, Cw, into rise in temperature. Now initial temperature was 30, now it is 75. So 75 minus 30, okay? Plus heat gained by calorimeter, Mc, Cc again. Earlier temperature was 30, now it has become 75, so 75 minus 30. 75 minus 30 is 45, okay? So I'll put that outside the bracket, 45. And Mw, Cw. Mw is what? 170. And Cw is 1. Specific capacity of water is 1. Plus Mc into Cc. Mc is what? 100 grams. And specific capacity of copper is 0.1. Right? This comes out to be 10 plus 170. That is 180 into 45. Right? And over here on LHS, what you get? Ms is what? 100 into 0.1, because it is made of copper sphere, into T minus 75. Correct? Now, this 10, 100 into 0.1 is 10, so I can write T minus 75 equal to 180 into 45 upon 10, that is 18 into 45. Now finally T will be 18 into 45 plus 75. Into 45 is 810 plus 75, that is 885 degree Celsius. This is the temperature of the, this was the temperature of the sphere initially, which I have to find, and I found it as 885 degrees Celsius. See, if two objects are brought in contact with each other, one is a hot object, other is a cold object, there is transfer of heat and the temperature of the resultant, means suppose I take two liquids at different temperatures and mix them, what will be the temperature of the mixture? Now this shortcuts, remember, if both are made of same material then specific heats will be same. In that case the resultant temperature of mixture will be m1 theta 1 plus m2 theta 2 upon m1 plus m2. If the masses are same but specific heats are different, okay, the two objects
liquid, solid, water, Z is of same masses, then resultant temperature of mixture will be theta 1 C1 plus theta 2 C2 upon C1 plus C2. And if the temperature, if their specific heats are same and their masses are also same, then the resultant temperature of mixture will be theta 1 plus theta 2 upon 2. Okay, so these are the shortcuts we will use in the next numerical. See, our numerical 23 says there are three bodies of same material and having masses m and 3m at temperature 40, 50 and 60 degrees Celsius respectively. If the bodies are brought in thermal contact with each other, the final temperature will be dash 45, 54, 52 or 48. Now what things are given? They are made of same material. So C1, C2, C3 will be same, that is C. Okay. Masses are different. For masses are M, M and 3M. Okay. And the temperatures, theta 1 is 40 degrees Celsius. Theta 2 is 50 and theta 3 is 60 degrees Celsius. Okay, you have to find the temperature of the final temperature of mixture. Final temperature, capital T, you have to find. I can take any symbol, I'll take capital T. Okay, now if you see this formula, if C1 and C2 are same, we can simply write m1 theta 1 plus m2 theta 2 upon m1 plus m2. This shortcut. So I will use that. T will be m1 theta 1 plus m2 theta 2 plus m3 theta 3 upon m1 plus m2 plus m3. Okay. Now m1, m2, m3, I have put the values m, m, 3m. Okay. So first we'll got m into 40 plus, I'm sorry, m is how much, okay, m into 40, then m into 50, right, and plus m into 60 upon m plus 3m, this will be 3m into 60. Okay, now what you get here, 40m plus 50m, 90m, 90 plus 180, that is 270m upon 4m, sorry, 270 upon 5m, and that is 270 upon 5, 5, 5 is 25, okay. 5 4s are 20. So temperature will be 54 degree Celsius. Okay. And 23rd answer is, yeah, B, 54 degrees Celsius. This is our answer. Understood this?